balloon decryocystoplasty, the way to go for failed probing or polio obstructions in patients suffering from congenital nasal acromial duct obstruction. We have no financial disclosures in this presentation. Congenital nasal acromial duct obstruction is a common disease presenting with watering of the eyes with or without recurrent discharge in children. It can be diagnosed either with positive Roplas or dye disappearance test. In most patients, there is a simple obstruction at the lower end of the nasal acromial canal. If not treated, patient can end up with corneal ulcer, localized infection, lacrimal abscess, or orbital cellulitis. The most commonly performed treatment for an unresolved congenital nasal acromial obstruction is probing. Although probing has a high success rate, failure is seen in 5% patients, with various factors, especially older children, faulty passage, firm obstruction or polio obstructions can lead to failed probings. These are some areas of obstruction other than the obstruction at the lower end of the nasal acromial canal which can complicate a probing procedure. In cases of failed probing, various options are available for the treatment, of which balloon decryoplasty probably is considered the gold standard. In this video, we will demonstrate balloon catheter dilation for treatment of persistent nasal acromial duct obstruction. These are two simple instruments other than the regular instruments otherwise required for doing any probing procedure. This is the balloon catheter made by a company called MediQuest and available by the name LacriCath. The LacriCath is 24 cm long. And it comes with a protective silicone cap over the balloon. For young children less than 30 months age, the balloon size is 13 mm in length and 2 mm dilation when inflated. For older children, the length is 15 mm and with inflation it dilates to 3 mm. This video shows the basic instruments required for performing a probing procedure and the additional two instruments, that is the inflation device and the balloon catheter for performing balloon decryocystoplasty. This is a Hawk 0° 2.8 mm straight sinuscope or a nasal endoscope for pediatric use. This is a cold dual light source which is attached to a fiber optic. Before starting the surgery, Otrivin nasal drops for children are instilled. This is followed by insertion of the laryngeal mask or an eye gel for securing the airway. Regurgitation on pressure over lacrimal sac or Roplas test is performed to confirm the site of obstruction and presence of obstruction. If it is negative, one may do lacrimal syringing. The punctum is dilated with the needleship punctum dilator from normal 0.3 mm to approximately 1.5 mm. The procedure begins with doing a probing procedure using a smart probe as shown over here. This probe is designed by us. It's a 0.65 mm probe with gradation at every 10 mm. It is also cannulated so that after passing around 25 to 30 mm of probe, one can start irrigating the probe and retrieve the dye in the nose either in the suction catheter or preferably direct visualization with the endoscope. Once the endoscope's placement is confirmed, the sister is asked to irrigate and the irrigation fluid is confirmed in the nose. After the confirmation, the probe is removed. In this particular patient, there was a very thick bony obstruction. Now starts the balloon decryocystoplasty. The silicone cover from the balloon is removed. The balloon is exposed. The balloon catheter is passed in a manner similar to the smart probe. Once the catheter negotiates the punctum, the passage becomes quite easy. The catheter is inserted up to the second marking. The probe placement is shown in this animation video. The placement is confirmed by doing a nasal endoscopy, or one may use traditional metal-to-metal touch approach to confirm the presence. Now the irrigating device is getting ready. Normal saline is withdrawn in the 10 ml syringe which is supplied along with the balloon catheter. After removal of all the air, the irrigating device is connected to the balloon catheter. The assistant is ready to mark the time. The inflation device is rotated so as to produce the atmospheric pressure of 8. It is kept for 90 seconds and then the device is allowed to be deflated. This clip gives a better look at how the atmospheric pressure is created and how the balloon is inflated for 90 seconds. The catheter is withdrawn and the balloon is reinflated and the inflation is kept for 60 seconds. The balloon catheter is then completely withdrawn and that marks the end of the procedure. This is the balloon decryocystography of another patient showing blocks at two different levels, one at the junction of lacrimal sac with the nasolacrimal canal and another one at the lower end of nasolacrimal canal. This is the post-operative picture of the same patient following balloon decryocystoplasty, demonstrating opened up nasolacrimal system. The success of balloon decryocystoplasty is in the range of 70 to 80%. The potential complications with this procedure are few and can be prevented by diligent use. One must avoid unnecessary force during placement of the probe and avoid pressures greater than 8 atmospheres. Bleeding is usually self-limiting and can be reduced with nasal vasoconstriction that can be achieved by installation of nasal vasoconstrictors. In patients with recurrence, a repeat probing with silicone intubation can be done. Cellulitis can be avoided with antibiotic use. One should not use this procedure in patients having active infection or facial trauma. Thank you very much for your kind attention.